Hi guys, Bobby Gass. This is a video about the early history of 45s. I have the first two that were ever made right here, eh? I've got a bunch of they used to color code them. I'm going to do a short video or show a short video that I stole of about the early 45s and the record players that played them. A lot of guys, they say they don't like them because they got to get up and change the record. Well, we didn't have to do all of that, right? I have also a bunch more of these green labeled early 1949 and 1950 early RCAs. They were country the green, right? But later on, they put them on a blue label. This is another Eddie Arnold one. They also had them on. I've got one red label one, right? This is Mario Lanza, if I remember. Yeah, this is Mario Lanza. Maria, wow, it's a great tune. I uploaded a couple of Mario Lanza tunes a long time ago. But before I show you the video that I stole, I also today I got in the mail the book, The War Diary of Claire Gass, Aunt Claire, well, my grandaunt Claire, right? It's got the pictures, you know, and the story of her and all of that. They made a, you know, she's been in film and on radio by the CBC and Radio Canada and a few other things. And I've talked about her before. Anytime I do a war video, I always mention Aunt Claire. And I also got in the mail today medical pot. 27% THC, 25.5% THC. I'm set for a while. Of course, I got lots of other stuff. Anyhow, let's show you the video here and get into the history of the early 45s. 45s is, I mean, I'm a 45 guy. I really am, right? I mean, it's what I grew up with. I mean, sure, later on in my late teenage years, and certainly my 20s, when I was in my 20s, I was buying albums and very, very few 45s. But, you know, I got about 4,000 45s right now.
In 1949, RCA announced their new system to the press. The details explained that this new, as yet unnamed format would be 7 inches across, would play at 45 RPM, and would be based around a changer unit. Now, record changers were nothing new. You could get changers for 78s, but apparently it was going to be integral to the experience with this new format. There was no definitive word on the maximum playtime of a 7-inch disc, but they definitely weren't going to be long players. Interestingly, the name was proving to be an issue. Since the LP held 45 minutes of music and the RCA disc spun at 45 RPM, they thought this might lead to some confusion. During development, it had gone by the name of Madam X, but in the end, they just stuck with 45. RCA were about a year behind the LP when they launched, so they were playing catch-up, and as a result they blitzed the press with advertising, taking over the first 20 or so pages of this issue of Billboard. Each page showed one of their top artists at the top, and then at the bottom they listed a total of 23 benefits of the 45. We're going to look at some of those later. You might have heard someone say in the past that the large hole in a 45 is there to make it easier for jukeboxes to handle them. And yes, they are easier for jukeboxes to handle with a large hole, but it's interesting to note that this was launched as a home system. When the 45 came out, there wasn't a single jukebox on the market that was able to play them. However, because of the efficient disc changer mechanism, the first 45 players were really jukeboxes for the home. And it just so happens I've got one of those early machines here. This is a 45EY2. They never sold these in the UK. However, this one comes from a chap on eBay who imports these in a broken state, fixes them up and modifies them so they can be used in the UK. Unfortunately, this process means they lose their tube amplification, but it also means I can demonstrate one in this video. If you wanted to run an original untouched one, your power supply would need to be 120 volts and 60 hertz. So I'll just give you a quick tour around it. There's not much to see. The part that's been repainted red is made of Bakelite. This is a basic standalone model with a built-in speaker, a volume control on the side, and around the back, that's where the power lead would originally have come out. This silver coloured section on the top is metal. We've got the simple tone arm, a 7-inch platter, and there's one switch that toggles the power and changes a record. The records are held on the silver section at the top of the centre spindle and are individually released by the internal mechanism, and you can stack up to 10 records on that top part, which they claimed would give you up to 50 minutes worth of music at the push of one button. In this advert you can see the similar 9EY3 model. This one looks to have a bigger speaker than mine. Below that in the range though is a model without a speaker, and that's for attaching up to an existing system. But there's a whole range of models here. One of these can also play 78s, but tellingly none of them are able to play a 33 and a third LP. Let's get back to that list of benefits of the new 45s. It's important to note that this list is mainly comparing them against the 78s, but some of the things mentioned here apply to LPs too. However, one thing they didn't mention, which is my favourite feature of the new format, and that's the coloured vinyl. You might tend to associate coloured records with a novelty now. They're often issued for a special edition of a re-release of an old record. The colour of the vinyl often matches something that's on the cover of the album. But back in 1949, RCA launched 45s with their own colour coding scheme. Green was for country and western, red classical, midnight blue popular classics, yellow for children's, and black for popular. Now, I haven't got them all here, but there was also sky blue for international and cerise or orange for blues and rhythm. That makes me wonder when we swapped around those words to R&B rather than B&R. But anyway, getting back to the coloured discs, they're also translucent. And as you can see, they really haven't lost any of their vibrancy, even after 70 years. But let's return to the benefits of 45 that are mentioned on this list. Now, some of these repeat themselves and some only really apply to retailers. So I'll pick out a few that are the most relevant. Number one, they sound better. Now, there's a couple of things here. They sound better than 78s, yes, but a 45 RPM record should also sound better than a 33 and a third. They also mentioned their golden throat system, which RCA had been touting on their radios for a few years by this point. It's about their speaker setup having a better overall sound quality. Moving on now to number two, plays easier. Automatic, easy to load, world's fastest changer. Well, I think it's time for a demo. Loading 10 discs is easy and can be done one-handed, as they say. So let's look at the changer mechanism in action. Yeah, it's definitely nippy and efficient. They weren't wrong, I'll give it that.
She's my Texarkana baby. Do I love her, Lordy love? Her pappy came from Texas and her ma from Arkansas. I'm twisted round her finger like a little piece of string, and yet I'm satisfied because she's such a precious thing. If she hauled off and slapped me, I would never feel the sting. She's my Texarkana baby. She's my Texarkana baby. Do I love her, Lordy love? Her pappy came from Texas and her ma from Arkansas. She's pretty as a picture and you ought to hear her name. It's sweet as sorghum syrup and good old blue ribbon cane. She gives me lots of sugar, and she never spills a grain. She's my Texarkana baby. She's my Texarkana baby. Do I love her, Lordy Lord? Her pappy came from Texas and her ma from Arkansas. One night I went a-callin' on my pretty little maid. I must admit to you I was a little bit afraid to offer her a diamond ring with one installment paid. She's my Texarkana baby. Texarkana baby, do I love her, Lordy Lord? Her pappy came from Texas and her ma from Arkansas. She's got two eyes that twinkle like a good old country star. She's got a perfect figure that'll stop you where you are. Why, every time I look at her, I think of my guitar. She's my Texarkana baby.